In this episode of Switching on the San Luis Western Railway, the power for the log train will first yard the rock cars that were previously placed on the inbound track by the rock job. Set the caboose over, grab the log loads, grab the caboose, and depart westbound. The power for the manifest will leave the engine facility, get his train and caboose, and depart eastbound. The layout will then be operated as a continuous loop. This is a folded oval, and the two sidings are placed equidistant. So, the two trains will always meet at Laurel and Hardy. The train speed is 15 scale miles per hour and takes about 7 minutes to complete one full circle. As an aside, all the switches and most of the rail in the yard are Code 70 Shinohara from the 1980s that I salvaged from my previous layout 40 years ago. I had to add some new Code 70 flex track. These switches are not DCC friendly, although they do work. The big disadvantage is when you are going trailing point and the switch is lined against you, the DCC will short out. This is because the two point rails are tied together electrically. Proper switch alignment is very important to avoid this. The other problem is that the power is passed via the switch points. Not a good idea, but I did save a lot of money and I'd never do it again. The other side of the layout is all modern PICO Code 83. Here is the breakpoint that makes the layout either a loop operation or end-to-end. I have made a piece of real estate that can be placed over the rails, giving a tail track end to the main line at Laurel and a tail to one leg of the Y. This makes, in theory, these two locations many miles apart. Today, this won't be in place. With it in place, the Y is just for turning power. With it removed, it allows trains to go either east or west. In the next episode, the layout will be run as end-to-end and a loop. A local will leave the yard, work at Carlin and Laurel, and return to the yard at the same time, dodging a passenger train that will be continuously looping.